I know that the scripture continues on, but I want to stop right there. I have a heart's desire to preach. Paul says that I know I've been appointed, and in my heart, I have a desire to preach. That's what Paul said. But now, what I want to talk about, what is it that God has given you the desire to do?
Come on.
Right.
Time with yourself.
Right, yeah.
That takes some reflection. I mean, you know, seeing what you're called to do.
That's right.
See, you can't look at what somebody else is doing and say, well, what God calls you to do. No, no, it's not that time right now. Now is the time that you have to look at your own self.
Come on.
And say, well, what is it that God has placed in my heart? What is my desire?
Come on.
What is it that God has given me? What kind of desire has He given me to do ministry?
Come on.
This is your time to do that now. Has it been to preach? Do you have a desire to sing? I do. Do you have a desire to prophesy? To teach? What is the desire that God has given you? What is it that's in your heart that you desire to do?
Yes.
That is part of the shape that God has shaped you to do ministry.
Right. Yes.
The scripture says, my constant ambition is to preach the gospel. See, we ain't preaching nothing else.
Huh.
We ain't preaching nothing else.
All right now.
We preaching the gospel.
Right.
That's what we preaching. The good news.
Yes.
From heaven.
All right.
You may hear me holler. You may hear me scream and shout. Uh-huh. But one thing about it, you're going to know that I'm preaching the gospel.
Yes.
I ain't preaching nothing foreign to you. Ain't trying to lead you astray and hoodwink you. You're going to get the gospel when you hear me preach.
All right.
Paul says that my ambition has been to preach the gospel. See, Paul knew what it was that he was called to do. Paul understood that part of my heart's desire is to preach this gospel. But then it goes further than that. Paul says that my constant ambition has been to preach the gospel where the name of Christ was previously unknown. Think about that for a minute. Yeah, take a look at the screen. Y'all got questions? Got my phone. Y'all can text me. And I answer while I'm preaching. Kingdom agenda. So I'm on and ready. Who's gonna be the first one? Somebody shout hallelujah. Paul says, my constant ambition has been to preach the gospel where the name of Christ was previously unknown. In other words, Paul says that to avoid building on another man's foundation. Paul says that I don't want to go and preach the gospel where ain't nobody never heard about Jesus before.
Right.
The Apostle Paul, in this, it said that he was talking about Spain. In the studies, Spain had not yet received the gospel. So it's believed that Paul says, I want to go to Spain.
All right.
Como se llama? Yo te quiero, Jesus. That's what I want to do. Keep preaching to the same ones and the same ones day after day and over and over. No, you got to leave them people alone, Paul says. I don't want to build on another man's foundation.
All right.
Take me somewhere where all they do, I mean, when they talk, they click. Make sound. I want to go somewhere that don't know who Jesus is. That was part of the desire that Paul had in his heart.
Amen.
That was part of his shape.
Amen.
The A in shape is ability. Paul went to see them and stayed and worked with them because he earned his living by making tents. That was one of the abilities that Paul had, was to make tents. That was another avenue that Paul could swim with the people.
Amen.
He could go and swim with the tent makers.
That's right.
Because they knew how to make tents.
That's right.
What is the ability that God has given you?
All right.
What is it that you know how to do that you can do among the people, the same people that do it, and that you can swim with?
All right.
And you can get in their life.
All right.
And you can be involved in what they're doing and how they're moving.
Okay.
What is the ability that God has given you? It was making tents for God.
Yes.
I mean, for Paul. Do you not? I know how to paint cars. I know how to operate a gunpowder.
Yes.
Among a host of other things. What is it that God has given you?
Yes.
Part of your ability so that you can use for ministry.
All right.
Not only that, he earned his living by making tents just as they did. And then he debated. So that was part of Paul's ministry, a part of the shape that Paul had. He could make tents and he could debate.
Mm.
Now I know we got some debaters. I know we got some debaters somewhere close by. You know, on the right side or the left side, in the front or the back. But God gave Paul the ability to debate.
All right.
To talk, to proclaim.
Uh-huh.
I might even say just a little bit to argue with somebody. To even argue with people, because see, he needed to get his point across.
Right.
So that people would understand who Christ was.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. It says that he debated in the synagogues every Sabbath, trying to convince both Jews and Gentiles. So Paul says he tried to convince. The Bible says that Paul tried to convince Jews and Gentiles.
Uh-huh.
Part of Paul's ability was to what? Number one? Number two?
Debate.
To debate. Y'all got that. Praise God. The P, Paul's personality. Paul's personality. For you have heard of my past. I persecuted the church. I persecuted the church. Part of Paul's personality, one thing that Paul did was persecuting the church. That word persecuted means to make, to run, or flee. To make the run or flee. So Paul's personality was, when Paul got locked in on something, when Paul really got locked in,
all right,
on what it was that he wanted to do,
uh-huh,
Paul was the type of cat that would go after it with everything he had in his heart, soul, and body.
That's right. That's right.
When Paul got locked in on it, Paul was the type of cat that would grind for him. Paul was the kind of cat that would go and get down for him.
Come on.
When he got locked in on it, there was no half stepping with Paul. Paul said, I persecuted. to destroy the church. Paul was the kind of cat that would chop it up with you. Then he would swim with you. But then as his personality also was that when he built that relationship with you, he would honor that relationship so much. And he would be so gentle with the relationship that he built with you. Just like a child, or just like a nurse would nurse, a mother would nurse her child.
All right.
That's just how much the relationship meant to Paul. He was the kind of cat that said, not only do I want to give you the gospel of God, but also I want to impart my very soul into you.
Alright.
Paul says, I want to live with you. I want to swim with you. I want to get involved in your life. That was Paul's personality. To get involved with the life of the people he came in contact with. And to go with him. I persecuted the church. And look how he persecuted me. He went after it. Not half-heartedly. Not lackadaisical. Not ho-hum. But he went hard. After what he got locked in on. The Bible says that he persecuted the church with a fanatical zeal. I'm talking about being crazy for Jesus. I'm talking about being a fanatic for Jesus. I'm talking about going places that everybody won't go for Jesus. I'm talking about doing things that everybody won't do for Jesus. Paul says that I persecuted the church and I persecuted with a fanatical zeal. You knew when I was coming.
All right.
My name preceded me. What you knew about me preceded me. So when I was on my way, my reputation was already in a place that I was going to, and you knew I was on my way. Paul said that he persecuted the church with a fanatical zeal. And then it says, and did my best to destroy. Are we giving our best to do what God has called us to do? Are we going after that calling that God has placed upon our life with the fanatical zeal and doing our best to do what God has called us to do? I'm not talking about thinking about everything that we've gone through and allowing that to stop us and hinder us from going after God. I'm talking about doing our very best at what God has called us to do. You might even say Paul had somewhat of an addictive personality. And what that means is, I've been saying it for the last 3 minutes. When you get locked in on something and you're going after it, then you're addicted to it. You don't want to hear nobody tell you, no, you can't go there. No, you can't say this. No, you can't preach that. No, you can't minister here. No, you can't minister there. No, you can't sing this. No, you can't prophesy. No, you can't move with your gift. No, you can't move with the spirit. No, we don't want you to move here. No. See, you don't want to hear all of that kind of stuff. But when you are going after what God has called you to do, as a matter of fact, you get frustrated when people put bounds and hold you and chain you and wrap you up, and you just can't get up loose to do what God has called you to do.
Come on.
Right, preaching,
young folks.
Ha! The Bible says that I was ahead of most of my contemporaries in the Jewish religion and had a boundless enthusiasm. That means Paul was so happy about doing what he was called to do, you couldn't hold him down.
Come on.
You couldn't stop him from doing what God called him. The same way we have to do.
Oh, yeah.
The same way we have to walk in ministry.
Oh, yeah.
The same.